Hello everyone, today's topic for presentation is virtual circuit packet switching. In this presentation, we are going to cover what is packet switching, types of packet switching, and detail about virtual circuit packet switching. Why we need to study packet switching? So, packet switching is used to optimize the use of channel capacity available in digital telecommunication network. Now, let's see what is packet switching. Basically, packet switching is standard switching technology for computer-to-computer communication and thus used by most communication protocols such as TCP, IP, etc. In packet switching, data is transmitted as discrete block called as packet, which are of variable length, which is transmitted in given time. Packets are comprised of header and actual message, which is shown in figure. Header is used to reach destination by its address. Now we see the actual working of packet switching, which is shown in figure. It shows that how message is transmitted from host 1 to host 2. The original message is shown by green, blue, and red box. So, green message is transferred from host 1 to host 2 via node A, node D, node G, and node H. Similarly, blue message is transmitted from host 1 to host 2 via node B, node E, node H. And red message is transmitted from host 1 to host 2 via node A, node B, node C, and node F. So now we see types of packet switching. So there are basically two types of packet switching. First one is virtual circuit packet switching, and second one is datagram. In this presentation, we are going to concentrate only on virtual circuit packet switching. So now we concentrate on what is virtual circuit packet switching. Virtual circuit packet switching is a packet switching methodology whereby a path is established between the source and final destination through which all the packets will be routed during a call. This path is called a virtual circuit because to the user, the connection appears to be a dedicated physical circuit. However, other communication may also be sharing the parts of the same path. Before the data transfer begins, the source and destination identify a suitable path for the virtual circuit. All intermediate nodes between the two points put on entry of routing in their routing table for the call. Additional parameters such as maximum packet size are also exchanged between the source and destination during call setup. The virtual circuit is cleared after the data transfer is completed. Figure shows the actual working principle of virtual circuit packet switching. Here are some advantages of virtual circuit packet switching. They are as follows. Packets are delivered in order since they all take the same route. The overhead in packets is smaller since there is no head for each packet to contain the full address. The third advantage is network can provide sequencing and error control. The fourth one is packets are forwarded quickly. And the last one is the connection is less reliable because network resources are allocated at call setup so that even during times of congestion. Now let's see some disadvantages of virtual circuit packet switching. So first disadvantage of the virtual circuit packet switching is the switching equipment needs to be more powerful since each switch needs to store detail of all the calls that are passing through it and to allocate capacity for any traffic that each call could generate. Recovery to loss of trunk is difficult since if there is failure of all call must be dynamically re-established over a different route. So now let's summarize what we have learned in this presentation. So we have learned the basic concept of packet switching, the types of packet switching, and the detail of virtual circuit packet switching and their advantages and disadvantages. This is a reference book for this presentation. Thank you for watching.